print on demand stores, they're being shut down and sued. Here's why Redbubble, Etsy, and Teespring are closing stores. Hey, are you worried? You should be, because these major stores are shutting down people right and left. In this video, I'm going to share with you why they're doing it and how you can keep your store open. And we're starting right now. Look, having a print on demand store can be great, but what if you build up that store and you're making money and things are going well, and all of a sudden you get shut down? You don't get any notice whatsoever, and they just shut your store down. Why are they doing it? What's going on here? This is craziness. It's happening everywhere. In this video, I'm going to explain to you why. Let's get started right now. Now, I get messages all the time from people who are saying, hey, JR, they shut down my Facebook ads account. They shut down this account. They shut down that account. But the one thing I'm hearing more and more is these stores, these Redbubbles, these Etsy's, all these Teesprings, these T-Launch stores are getting shut down. And I figured out why. Let's take a look at one comment here. This here is from Money Guy. 2 hours ago, my Redbubble store has been active for 3 weeks and I haven't gotten a single sale. Can you look at it and let me know what I'm doing wrong? Hey, I'll do that. If you guys want to post something like that, here's the link, and I X'd it out so you guys couldn't see it. But here's the funny thing. When I clicked on it, look what I got. I got this simple message right here from Redbubble. You found a glitch. We've been notified of a 500 server error. Now, they shut down the store, and I probably know why. I can't look and see, but I've seen enough stores to know why this one probably got shut down. And I want to share this with you so it doesn't happen to you. Now, here's the truth. A lot of people will start a store, an online store, drop shipping store, where they're doing, you know, t-shirts and hats and jackets and all that. And they really don't have the business sense they need yet. They don't know what the rules are. And I mean, these rules, when you go to these sites and set up your stores, are just long and they go on forever, and they don't read them. And that's the problem right there, guys. They don't read them, and they don't have to tell you why they shut your store down. They can just shut it down. So the only way to protect yourself from any of this is to make sure you understand the rules and you play by them fairly. Now, this is the exact reason I did this video, is to help you guys out so you don't have these problems. I'm going to give you a legal disclaimer. I am not a lawyer. Okay. I did not go to law school. I do not know the law inside and out. And if you want legal advice on what to do on your site, don't ask me. I'm just a YouTube guy. Okay. But with that having been said, I'm going to show you some examples and talk to you about why these people are having problems. Now, here you go. Let's play a little game. You got 5 seconds to tell me why this picture here is illegal. All right. And we'll count to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Do you know why? If you know why, type it in the comments. Type in the comments why you think this picture here is illegal. Why this picture, if you put it on a t-shirt or something, is going to get you shut down. Why is that? Why? Because it's a copyright infringement. Okay. Copyright is a federal law. Let me put it up here on the screen so you can see it. Copyright is a federal law of the United States that protects original works of authorship. A work of authorship includes literary, written, dramatic, artistic, musical, and certain types of other works. Okay. Next part. Listen to this, guys. Copyright attaches as soon as the original work is created. You don't have to file anything. Okay. As soon as it's created, and it applies to both published and unpublished works. As soon as you type words, click the shutter on your camera, or for many of you, hit the home button on your iPhone, apply paint to a canvas or paper, or lay down tracks for your next hit, you've got copyright, with some exceptions. So it's not something you actually have to file with the copyright office, though it's not a bad idea to. You could have that copyright. You could have taken, let's say, a picture, okay, and put it online, and it's been there for 5 years, and somebody uses it, you can sue them for copyright infringement. You can actually file your copyright at that time, right before you sue them. You could do that. Now, listen to this next part. Copyright is an automatic right and does not require the author to file special paperwork, as in the case for trademark and patent. Registration is required to enforce the rights, but as a matter of right, an author is not required to register anything to get the right to use the circle C showing the work is copyrighted. So keep that in mind. You can, if you come up with something, if you come up with a design, if you write something or whatever, you want to copyright it, all you do is put the C there. That's all you got to do. I'm going to tell you, because a lot of people do this, they steal pictures. They steal them. Now, they don't mean to. I understand. I get it. They don't mean to. They go to Google. They search images. They find an image that works for what they want, and they use it. Now, I'm not recommending you do that because you will get in trouble. Now, the question is, a lot of you guys will say, well, I see people all the time using Google images and they never get in trouble. They never have a problem. So it shouldn't be a problem for me. But that's not how it works. It's kind of luck of the draw. You may get an image today and it's the first image you ever had. You put it on your website and somebody sees it and they sue you. They sue you big time. Okay, they can sue you for $10,000, $20,000, $50,000. Here's the funny thing about the United States, it's arbitrary. You know, there's no set amount. So they can come to you and say, well, I want to sue you for $50,000 for this picture. And they can sue you for that, okay? I can sue you for $100,000. I've seen people get letters like this. And there's a lot of lawyers out there too that will just send out letters with, you know, these fake lawsuits or whatever. They're really just people trying to collect money from people. But the fact is it can really happen. So you do have to worry about it. So how can you protect yourself? Well, the first thing you can do is you can, when you search in Google, is you can look for Creative Commons, okay? Pictures that actually have the rights to actually reuse them. Now, this is not a guarantee. This is not a guarantee, I'm telling you, but it is one way that you can protect yourself by searching these images that have this little drop down here that will allow you to use the pictures without any accreditation to anybody else. Now, you may be saying to yourself, well, can I just search copyrights for pictures? No, you can't, because like I just told you, if you have a picture, if you have a design, you're not required to copyright the picture to have the copyright advantage, to have the copyright protection. So you can copyright at any point you want, but the copyright goes into effect as soon as you publish it in the public domain. What's another way you can protect yourself? Well, you can create your own stuff, okay? You can create your own ideas, your own slogans, your own pictures, you know, your own videos, and then you don't have to worry about it because you created it. The other thing you can do is you can pay a site that has copyrighted pictures but allows you to use them. So, you know, maybe you want music and you go to Epidemic Sound, or maybe you want pictures so you go to, you know, Shutterstock Photos or one of these sites like that, and you pay a fee for the pictures, okay? That's one way to go about it. But there's other things that you want to be aware of. Now, I'm going to show you another picture right here, and this is a picture of Vincent Van Gogh. I'll give you 5 seconds. Can you use this picture of Vincent Van Gogh? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, put in the comments, is it a yes or no? Can you use this picture of Vincent Van Gogh? Obviously, this is a famous painting. Okay, so obviously somebody had some rights to it, but can you use it? That's the question. So put in the comments, yes or no, can you use this? Can you use Vincent here on your website? The answer is yes, you can. Yes, it's an original work. But if the copyright has expired, of which this one has, it's been many, many, many years, and I'm gonna show you a chart for that in just a second, or it's entered the public domain, then you're allowed to use it, even though somebody did have a copyright. So I'll put it up on the screen here, the definition. A public domain image is defined as a photo, clip art, or vector whose copyright has expired or never existed in the first place. These images can be used for almost anyone for personal and commercial uses. There are 3 ways that the public domain image occur. Okay, now check this out, guys. The image is assigned to the public domain through a Creative Commons 0 license or similar release. The image is not copyrightable, or the copyright for the image has expired. Now, you will find that museums, libraries, photographers sick of traditional stock photos have released thousands of public domain images online, and you can actually use them. Okay, it makes them easily accessible for the public. And yep, that means designers too. So if you want to use those in your design, you can do that. Now, I want to offer you guys, and you're going to find it in the download section, a list of all the public domain images that you can actually use. You'll find those at the list. You'll find that in the description below. So click on that and you can go ahead and get those and use those for your websites or whatever. So keep in mind, these sites like Redbubble, sites like Etsy, any of these sites where you're doing your print on demand stuff, they want you on there. They want you to sell your products. They want your designs, because that's the only way they make money, is if they have products to sell. And since they don't charge you fees, The only way to make money is if you sell products. So if you're thinking, well, these people just want me out of business, they don't like me, they don't want me here, that's why they shut me down. It's just not true. It's because you did something wrong. And generally it's because of copyright infringement, because they are ultimately responsible for their website. So if they allow you to put these pictures on their website that are obviously copyright pictures, then they could get shut down, and they don't want that to happen. So they have this responsibility to actually police, monitor, and rid that site of anything that is copywritten material. But I hear it all the time. I hear it, you know, I hear it on YouTube all the time. People say, well, YouTube doesn't like me. They're not sending me any traffic. You know, they're not recommending my videos. I never get recommended videos. It's not that. It's because you're not doing what they want. Maybe your video's not long enough. Maybe it's, you know, one that they can't monetize because you use foul language in it. Maybe your channel gets low watch time. Maybe you're sending people off of YouTube. They watch 10 seconds of your video and you're sending them to your website, and they see that, you know, you're sending all these people away, and your channel is just a black hole, and they know if they send traffic to it, the people are gone. So there's reasons, and you've got to understand whoever that third party is, you know, what their reason is for being there. These sites like Etsy and Redbubble and all that, the reason for being there is they want to sell product and make money off it. Okay, that's what they want to do. YouTube wants to have people come on to YouTube. They want them to watch videos and continue watching and stay on the platform, and then they want to be able to run ads to them. Okay, so if you're not allowing them to, but you're sending them off the website, or your videos aren't engaging enough, or they don't watch enough, or if your videos aren't long enough, they can't run ads, or if you're not monetized and they can't run ads, they've got no reason to suggest your videos. They just don't. Okay. So keep that in mind. You know, you're going to be safe and you're going to be fine as long as you follow the rules. I would recommend on any of these sites that you actually sit down and read the rules, you know, before you put your products up there. It can cause you a lot of headaches if you don't do that. So I highly recommend it. Now, if you haven't done so, you need to get my course. There's a $97 course down there. I'm giving away absolutely free. All you need to do is click the link, no credit card required, and you can grab it. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, I need you to. I mean, I really, really, I just need you. You right there. You right there in the blue shirt. Uh-huh. The blonde hair girl right there. I need you. I need, yeah, you, the bald headed guy. I need you. I need you. I need you to subscribe. Please do so. That was some pitiful begging, but I really do want you to subscribe. And once you've done that, don't forget to ring the bell, turn on all bell notifications. When you do that, you will know when I do a new video. You won't have to come searching. You don't have to waste your time. You're not going to miss anything, because I'm going to notify you as soon as that video goes up. So make sure you do that. What else? How about a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm? We like that one, don't we? Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I really appreciate it. Put your comments below. If you have questions about this, if you've had problems with copyrights, if you've had problems with losing your accounts, put that below. If you like this video, say I like it. Just put that in the comments below. I really appreciate you being here, and I'll see you, guess what, in the next video.